Hey everyone, in this video we're going to look at this crazy integral. The integral from pi on 2 to 5 pi on 2 of e to the tan inverse of sine x over e to the tan inverse of sine x plus e to the tan inverse of cosine x dx. While it looks pretty crazy, we can actually calculate this pretty efficiently. The first thing we're going to do is introduce a new integral, and we'll call it j. J will be almost the same, however instead of a sine in the numerator, we'll have a cosine. The reason we've introduced another integral is so that we can find some relationships between them. Notice that if we add the two integrals together, the numerator and denominator cancel each other out. This leaves us with the integral of 1, from pi on 2 to 5 pi on 2. This works out to be equal to 2 pi. Now we know that I plus j equals 2 pi. Our second integral was chosen to be very similar for good reasons. We can convert between the two of them using a very simple substitution. If we're starting off with I, we'll need to turn that sine of x into a cosine of u. The easiest way to do that is to set u to pi on 2 minus x. With this substitution, we turn all of the sines into cosines and the cosine into sine. Remember that we'll have to multiply this by negative 1 since du is negative dx. Also, after doing the substitution, our bounds have changed. We're now integrating from 0 to negative 2 pi. Although the bounds are backwards, this is actually useful because we can use the negative sign to switch over our two bounds. Luckily, our function has a period of 2 pi, so we can legitimately change the bounds of our integral from negative 2 pi to 0 to pi on 2 to 5 pi on 2. And this is just our integral j. What we've managed to show with this substitution is that our two integrals are actually equal to each other. I equals j. At this point, we've actually finished most of the work. We're left with a system of linear equations that can be solved easily by substitution. Since I equals j, we can replace the j in the second equation with another I, leaving us with 2i. Finally, we can divide both sides of the equation by 2, showing that I equals pi. While this was just one example, introducing another integral into the mix and finding similarities between them can be an incredibly useful technique. If you have any questions or spotted any mistakes, feel free to leave a comment.